Today is the 21st of May. Nice job. Here. Yes, Tanya. The bag was checked. Quite a place. Alright, come on. Oh, there he is again. There. Here's my favorite airplane, the C-54. I was used in the Berlin airlift. Okay, here's Tanya in front of the C-54 that was used in the Berlin airlift.
I'm right at the main gate at the exit.
Beautiful airplane. Still in excellent shape. Hey, let's go inside, okay? Now way out in the distance there's the B-2 bomber. And I think we're probably going to get a closer look at it here. Here it comes. What a beautiful piece of machinery.
There it goes.
Here it comes. Delta wing. Wow. Wow. Unbelievable. Unbelievable. There he is again. Well, an airlift, started on 1948-49. To commemorate Operation Vidal. Amen.
Look, we're here in front of the C-54, which was used in a Berlin airlift, and I was a small kid on the receiving end, and they brought in all the food and coal for the Berliners to survive. the Russian blockade, and it was very successful. So this is a real privilege to see this airplane here that was actually in the airlift in Berlin between 1948 and 1949. I'm going to go inside now and take a look at what it looks like on the inside. Thank you.
Yeah. So afraid
with that opening.
Jesus, all right.
He's a German.
All right, now we're in the cockpit of the C-54. C-54? Got all the flight instruments.
We also rebuilding a C-97.
Throttles, mixed prop.
Until they said, tell me, I'll find out. Maybe I'll get all the M124s while you're at it. You can air show people to score for $10,000
every time he goes someplace. Yeah. Been a while.
It's
been
modernized a little bit.
Yeah.
Improved.
Well, let's see what's inside here. Mobile radar units used during the 1948 and 1949 building radar.
Controls.
He's gonna grind.
fellow that I'll never wrong.
Chattanooga choo-choo,
won't you choo-choo me home?
So, young man, what's your association with this Berlin Airlift outfit?
Well, my father got involved about 6 years ago, and I heard about like all the trips that he was able to go on because of this around the country, and then he was able to get me involved.
Oh, wonderful. What do you actually do for this?
I'm still a high school student.
Pardon me?
I'm still in high school.
Oh, okay.
Yep, well, finally that's graduating good. This year.
All right, good. How old are you?
18.
18, yeah. All right. Well, nice meeting you.
Nice to meet you, too.
Yeah. I was on the receiving end. I'm from Berlin.
Okay.
I was one of the kids looking out for the candy. I never got any because the big boys always pushed me out of the way, but it was fun just going after the parachutes, you know? So, very good. Well, you're involved in a worthwhile cause here, I'm telling you.
Definitely.
It's good to remember. What's your name?
Jeff Grubesich.
Jeff, what's your last name?
Grubesich.
Oh, yeah. I got it right here. All right. Good. A lot of noise out there, huh? All right. Well, thank you very much.
You're welcome.
Okay.
Huh? Yeah, you're going to have to get over that air flight that,
So...
Can I drive over there?
Can't get up there.
I'm gonna drive over here. Can I drive?
You can look at it.
Hold on, Hunter.
Oh, I'm going to find
them. Mommy, are those tux for?
And here are the Canadian snowbirds. Let's zoom one in here. There they are.
He just turned 20 years old, and I've been told, girls, that he's single. So you might want to see what it looks like when he hits the ground out here.
Hey, how are you?
Hey, how are you guys?
Good.
Oh, it's been a while.
Okay, I've been informed this is the hot pass, and we'll be exiting the airplane on this pass from high overhead. Looking straight up, we're going to look for chute. Probably just get right in there, straight up over the crowds where he will exit the airplane.
That'll be like really retired.
He's looking out the door, trust me. I'm in first class, Jared Zell.
Being an American, where at least I know I'm free. And I won't forget the man who died, who
Jumpers are out and the smoke is on. Immediately upon exiting the aircraft, these jumpers will fly their bodies apart to gain separation, using their hands, arms, legs, and shoulders as flight controls. They then fly together to exchange a 14-inch mahogany baton. They will now prepare to separate and deploy their main parachutes. And there you have, ladies and gentlemen, the high-flying black and gold of your United States Army parachute team, the Golden Knights. The parachutes used by the Golden Knights are a flexible wing glider, constructed of a lightweight rootstock nylon. These parachutes have an inherent forward airspeed of up to 22 miles per hour. To turn left, the jumper pulls down on the left steering line. To turn right, the jumper simply pulls down on the right steering line. As the jumper nears the ground, they will pull down on both steering lines simultaneously to perform the safest and softest possible landing. Mr. Charlie Hillard, former team leader of the Christian Aerobatics team, and Mr. Steve Snyder, parachute manufacturer, exchanged the first baton in 1957. It was then believed that two jumpers in freefall could not possibly make contact. Ladies and gentlemen, as he's concentrated on the target area, a small black dot in the center of the target. Look at the momentum on his face. And there you have, ladies and gentlemen, a beautiful on-target landing. This is in honor of the great state of New Jersey. And there you have, ladies and gentlemen, another beautiful on-target landing. He's smooth with his movements on his toggles, slowing the parachute down, pretty much coming straight down on the parachute. And there you have, ladies and gentlemen, yet another beautiful dead center landing into the target area. Ladies and gentlemen, it would appear that they're standing on each other's shoulders, but that is not the case. You can fly your parachute up to the hands of another jumper. The pilot is now taking it into the downwind leg of the jump run. And a base leg, 90 degrees to the target. He then turns it into the wind. Please watch, for you can hear the command break. And there you have, ladies and gentlemen, the high-flying black and gold of your United States Army parachute team, the Golden Knights. Ladies and gentlemen, if you ask Texas, he is an airborne recruiting liaison with 4,025 freefall parachute jumps, Sergeant First Class Jason Davis. Team for the 2005 air show season. All members of your United States Army parachute team, the Golden Knights. Now, we're keeping with long-standing Golden Knights tradition. We would like to present today's baton to a distinctive members of today's audience.
Riggins Oil Company, Geico, Ricky Slade Construction Incorporated, Romano Hearing and Testing Professional Associations, Sorrow Plumbing and Heating, Steelman Photographics, TFAL, Walmart, Wood Street Partners, Weibel Advertising, and Zarco Enterprises. Now again, if you're up there at the nose of the C-47, tell me where to take out a subscription to
Pime on Sunday morning, 7:55. Suddenly, ladies and gentlemen, the sound of aircraft. Indeed, our Royal Grace and Pine has just been invaded. The date, December the 7th, 41. You are there! Laying 200 miles to the north is the Imperial Fleet under the command of engage in the discussions for peace. Suddenly, the Nakajima B-5 intake with a specially designed torpedo between the wheel wells. They've been working for over a month to get this torpedo to run shallow in the water of Pearl Harbor. It's only about 40, 45 feet deep. Three of these aircraft come in, aiming right at the United States battleship, the Oklahoma. They release the bombs. They go into the shallow water. They run into the side of the Oklahoma. She explodes with such force and rolls over onto her right side. It takes over a month before we get all of the men, both alive and dead, 800 of them, out of the Oklahoma. High above the Ayachi D-389, it rolls up, it gains its altitude, it comes over, it rolls upside down with a 250-pound armor-piercing bomb. It comes down on the foredeck of the United States battleship, the Oklahoma. Struck right alongside the number two gun emplacement. It goes through deck one. It goes through deck two into deck three into a huge magazine. This great ship explodes into flames with such force. 1,100 of America's sons died in the Arizona. They sleep there today. Mitsubishi A6M0, the fastest aircraft in the Pacific theater at this particular time. With over 900 horsepower, it has a top speed of over 300 miles an hour, has the capability of two 30 caliber machine guns in the wings. The only thing we have out there right now, besides small training aircraft, are the P-40 Warhawks. Two of them greatest free nation in the world. Do you believe that, Millville, New Jersey? Mike Burke, Dan Reedy, Ron Wright, Jess Butenhoff, John Story, Skip Rawson, Doug Durr, Tom Hill and Robert Nishimura are our ground support guys. Bob West and the entire pyrotechnics gang is out there on the other side of the field. My name is Ken Kreitz. I want you to take this to the bank. Be proud of who you are. Wave that flag when you walk into any place. And when somebody says something bad about the greatest free nation in the world, just tell them you're wrong. God bless you.
Yeah.
We are Torah, Torah, Torah.
Ken, I don't think you like your job very much.
Hey, Jeff.
To the quiet of the 65 horsepower J3 Cub. Then, of course, we're going to close our show with the one and only friends from North, the Canadian Forces Snowbird Air.
Now here's the opportunity.
Here, let me point so you can see.
Right. Wow, he's an acrobatic flyer, boy. Look at that. Wow, gotta come out somewhere. There he is. Gonna follow the trail. Wow. He's something else, huh, Tanya? Upside down.
Upside down. 2 points back here.
Wow, he's gone.
Wow. Two hands. Back to the left now. Stop that vertical rope. One side to the other side. Stop the vertical penetration right about there. Caps it off. This airplane turning back and up right with the old tool rope. Tail slide down through his own smoke. That's right, the airplane was actually backing up down to his own.
Wow.
Now, it's funny, you can sit the front back of the airplane and fly along with it, whoever. Oh my God, what's a good one? I gave you 10 flies, where it pushes across up, hope you don't turn around. Points it up straight back, around, push it outside. There's about 3 to 4 negative G's outside.
Wow.
Something else.
Isn't that something? Okay, goodbye Millville Airshow until next year. That was great.
Thank you.
Yeah. No, it's okay, I got it. And there he is again. And there he is again. There we go. Little slow flight. They're starting the engines while we're waiting for the bus here. The big line.